Here are the contenders. The Mitsubishi Colt Rally Art, the Suzuki Swift Sport, the Renault Sport Twingo, and the 500R Bath.
A gang of angry hot hatchlings desperate to bully each other into submission. And we're going to whittle them down. And we're going to find out who's the best.
Johnny, what are you wearing?
Athletic clothing. This is a sports day.
Children.
What's the issue?
I can't work with you like that. Well, it's disturbing.
Test one is a half-mile sprint. The loser will be sent home crying into its Ribena.
Right, so let them go.
Let them go.
3, 2, 1.
Always wanted to do that.
Oh, yes, oh, it's the Colt way out in front.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that, Fitz coming up on the line, on the line.
Whoa. So the two turbo cars are in front.
I call it a Fiat.
Dog-based Colt rally art.
It's neck and neck.
Yeah.
Colt,
yeah.
Abarth.
First to finish is the Colt, followed closely by the Abarth, then the Swift.
The slow learner is the Renault Sport Twingo.
So, Twingo came last, Twingo goes home first.
Time for the next discipline.
Right, these are fairly cheap little cars here, so in theory, a cheap person like myself is probably going to get the best out of them, which is why I'll be driving.
You drive?
Have a look at that. It's a stopwatch. Oh, by the way, you might want this as well, Tiff, because it is a sports day, after all.
Do I have to hold this egg all the time?
Come on, get your eggs in.
Oh, God.
Test two is all about handling. First up, the Suzuki Swift.
3, 2, 1, go!
All right.
Okay, I'm gonna balance it. Oh, egg's gone.
Well, egg's gone.
Right,
so,
go.
Yeah, I've got the traction off.
So good,
I'm
yes.
Steering a bit, but it's...
Then more effort. This is the Suzuki Swift Sport. Go for the line, get back, get back, finish!
The Swift sets a time of 33.53 seconds. On to Johnny's favourite, the 500 Abarth.
Put it in sport mode, which is ridiculous, because a car on this shouldn't have sport mode.
It doesn't feel that nimble, not compared with my Suzuki.
The turbo's not having a chance to really spool up with your short little Tiff spec slalom.
Oh, you've just got it all over me. I've got eggy filth all over me.
It's slower than the Swift with a 34.38. So how fast will the Colt be?
Go!
Okay, so you sit nice and low. Oh, this turns in really nice.
Oh, and then it runs wide.
And then it understeers like an absolute witch.
Come on, work harder, come on. You're slacking. Will it get into the final against the Suzuki? Oh.
A 34.59 means no more games for the Colt.
So, two cars left, one crucial test to go, the flying lap. And now I have to hand the keys over to everyone's favourite racing uncle, Tiff Nadell.
It's about time. Oh, tight chicane first corner.
Oh, crikey, crikey.
Oh, it doesn't want to know.
It understeers. That's the grass and the cone.
I think 105, 108. Oh, and it's never going to make this corner.
Oh, shit!
Oh, never.
Change down mid-corner, that's a cone! And the curve. Oh, you naughty, naughty uncle.
Here comes the finish. Cross the line.
I can smell smoke.
Now. 1 minute 40 sets the pace and puts the pressure on the Suzuki.
Ready, steady.
Oh, oversteer is just lovely. The Abarth washed really wide and understeered this.
Almost on the grass.
No grass for this one.
Oh, you dirty man.
But it turned.
Dirty man.
That's the curve, and that's...
We're heading for the line. Heads
go
down.
Go on.
That is going to stop the clock. No! So, a much more balanced, much more enjoyable, poised ride. No fashion gimmicks. But the time was...
1:41.90.
1.8 seconds slower than the more powerful Abarth. So, Suzuki loses, but it put up a hell of a fight.
This was more fun.
More fun. Definitely more fun.
And cheaper.
And cheaper. But there was only one winner, and that was the Abarth 500, which you must be delighted with, Johnny. It's got the turbo power that gave it the legs around these long runways. It's our winner.